Originally, I'm a founder member of the group called the Whistlebinkies of a certain benchmark in the folk tradition. But since then, moved on, made albums, toured China, everywhere else. I've left the group, they still carry on. But then I now stay in Partick. In Partick, in Lismore Bar. Partick, as you know, is almost like a wee village inside of Glasgow, which it originally was at one time. And folk music has been progressed and been encouraged in this bar. And from there up to the Old Moor elsewhere. And of course, there's the Partick Community Centre, which has encouraged it as well. With Mick West running the folk club and everything, and so I was approached to do this festival here for the McEwan's Live in Your Pub scene. And of course, I formed another wee band called Tapsalteerie, which, for those who do not know, is a Scots word for the world upside down, which suits me. But there, for it progresses from then, and it's been a great festival, this.
So you're
Partick Festival.
You're living in Partick?
I'm living in Partick, yeah.
And
I'm what you call halfway up Byers Road, so I'm in the Partick end of Byers Road,
as
they call it. Not the snotty end, which is the top end.
Okay, so just tell me a little about the guys who are playing with you today.
Well, there's Jim Watrett, who is basically an artist who qualified through art school and paints, draws, but he's also a very good guitarist and singer, and he's drawn to folk music. So we met in the Isle of Arran years ago, about 15 years ago, and since then we have joined forces, especially since I left the Whistlebinkies, which, by the way, I still play with now and again as a guest in certain occasions.
So would you say that the folk scene in Glasgow, in Partick especially, no, there is one.
Well, there definitely is, and this has proven it. But they had a couple of festivals over the past 3 or 4 years that they used to hold the football pitch, and they had it there with their wee parade and the Mayfest, the Rain Me Partick Mayfest thing, which was totally successful. And I always ended up in here, or in the annex, which is Stuartville Street, for the benefit of those who do not know.
So have you seen much of this year's festival?
Yes, I have.
Is there anything you found quite memorable?
It was, last night with the Irish, Joe Burt and the fiddlers from Ireland, and the other fiddlers, Scottish fiddlers and Irish fiddlers, getting together. It was just blow your mind time. That's McAllister, Joe Burt and Adrian O'Rourke, that was it. So, but it was, to see them on the stage was just like blow your mind, blast you away with the amount of music and the harmony and the ambience that came out of that was just like, it's been a long time since I've heard fiddle playing like that. You know, even in Scotland. You know what I mean? A long time, I'm talking. I have to go back to the 60s before I heard people like that. You know, when these three guys got up on that stage and just played. And then, not only just did that, but they came back to the pub here and played just off the bat.
Tell me something a little bit about the songs and tunes you're going to do today.
Well, basically it'll be mostly Scots songs, tradition, and Scottish tradition, you know. I'll just come from the top of my head, what I'm doing. I've nothing arranged. This is not arranged, this has just come straight off the bat. Whatever comes up, you know.
Thanks very much for your time.
Okay, thank you.
And I wish a good session.
Thank you very much. I come in by the rainbow of the
Yeah, a bunch of the boys were boozing up in the Malamut saloon. The kid that handles the music box was playing a ragtime tune. All them golden slippers, all them golden slippers. Below and into the din and the glare. She stumbled a man afresh from the creek, stout, dirty, and loaded bare. Now he looked as though he'd one foot in the grave and scarcely the strength of a louse. He took the poke of dust in the bar and the coppers in his house. Oh, some men's faces just grip your eyes and they kind of hold them hard like a spell. And such was he, they looked to me like a man who lived through hell. Well, I figured into who he was, wondering what he might do. I turned my head and there looking at him was a lady that's known as Luke. Well, the ragtime kid was away for a drink like the rest of us.
That's no end of poem.
Didn't matter. So with this, we're near the stool. The stranger turned and he seemed the start of a daze until the old piano box fell away of his wandering gaze. In a buckskin shirt that was green with dirt and sand, and I saw him sway. When his talent hands moved over the keys, my God, but that man could play it! Hey, played another tune that made you think of Daisy Chains playing around the little burn with a girlfriend or two. And then he played another tune, and it seemed like a pent-up flood. And a thought came back of an ancient wrong, and my eyes were red with anger. The thought came back of an ancient wrong that stung like a frozen lash. And all of a sudden the music stopped with a clash. The stranger turned in his eyes, they burned in a most peculiar way. Boys, he said, you don't owe me and none of these given. Damn! But I want to state, my words are straight, I bet this poke of dust there true that whether you use a hand to hell, that man is dead with
Dan McGraw.
Well, the lights went up. A woman screamed, ah! And two guns roared out in the dark. The lights went on. Two men lay stiff and stark. Pissing his head, pumped with a lead, lay dangerous Dan McGraw. And the miner, fresh from the creek's lay clutched to the breast. The lady that's known as now, I ain't so wise as those lawyer guys, but strictly between us two, the woman who kissed her and pinched his poke was the lady that's known as Luke.
Oh,
We landed in Salerno on a holiday with Kate, the old
Thank you.